chemical reaction is where multiple substances are transformed into a new substance or new substances. This means that their actual chemical structure at a molecular level has changed. The substances going into the reaction are called the reactants, while the new substance or substances created are called the products. In order for a chemical reaction to occur, particles must collide. We call this collision theory. If two particles collide with enough energy, then the bonds will break and atoms will be open to form new bonds with other atoms and therefore creating the new substance. The level of energy required at collision for the reaction to actually occur is called the activation energy. For a collision to be a successful one, where the two reactants actually react together, they need to collide with enough energy and in the correct orientation. There are five ways to speed up a chemical reaction. The first is to increase the temperature. When we increase temperature, we increase the kinetic energy of the particles. This means that they will move around more and quicker. You can see this in the animation on the right. When this happens, we increase the likelihood that particles will collide and that they will collide with enough energy for the reaction to occur. The second is increasing the concentration of one or both of the reactants. When we increase the concentration, there are more reactant particles. If there are more particles in the solution, then there's a higher likelihood that collisions will occur. By increasing the concentration of one of the reactants, the rate of reaction will increase. And by increasing the concentration of both, the rate of reaction will increase even further. The third way we can increase the rate of a chemical reaction is by increasing the surface area of the reactants. What we mean when we say this is to crush up any solid reactants. For example, if we had a cube of sugar versus a teaspoon of sugar granules, the sugar granules will dissolve faster. While this example isn't a chemical reaction, it does help us visualize why this works. By crushing up the reactant into smaller parts, there's more surface area available for the other reactant to reach. In a cube or a large lump, there are many particles in the center that the other reactant cannot even get to. This is why increasing the surface area of the reactants or crushing it up will lead to an increase in the rate of reaction. The fourth way to speed up a chemical reaction is by adding a catalyst. A catalyst is a substance that helps speed up the rate of reaction without being used up in the reaction. There are two ways a catalyst can do this. A catalyst can reduce the activation energy by providing another path for the reaction to take place. Or a catalyst can also help the particles with their orientation. So when they collide in the right place for the particles to react. This means more successful collisions and therefore a quicker reaction rate. The final way to speed up a rate of reaction is to increase pressure. Now, this is only appropriate for reactions happening between two gases. By increasing the pressure of a vessel containing two or more gases, you are effectively reducing the volume. This pushes the gas particles closer to one another and therefore increases the likelihood of more frequent successful collisions. Hopefully, this video has helped you to understand the five ways that a chemical reaction can be sped up.